WeGoDo Tutorials is not sponsored by or affiliated with the Godot game engine. Welcome to the Maslow's Motivational Model episode. My name is Josie and I'll be your guide for this episode. I also have a website at godotutorials.com, so please feel free to check that out. In this episode, I will be going over the following: why learning about the motivational model is important to making games. Then I'll be going over each individual hierarchy of needs. And finally, I'll quickly talk about potential for abuse. So, let's start off with why every game designer should learn about the motivational model. And it's quite simple in theory. Game designers need people to be motivated to pick up your game, and then be continually motivated while playing your game. In the next episode, we will dive into motivation and biology, but for now, in this episode, let's just stick to Maslow's motivation model, as it's a great place to start. On top of being a great place to start on game design, it's also a great place to start when coming up with game ideas. Now, a game idea can come from anywhere, but knowing where our games lie in the motivational model will help us zone in on certain aspects of the game design experience we are trying to create for our players. This leads us to Maslow's motivational model. Maslow's motivational model, also referred to as Maslow's hierarchy of needs, is a theory of human motivation created by Abraham Maslow. The idea is that human motivation is predictable, and that we are capable of predicting what people are motivated by, and how best to motivate others to do something based on where they are in the motivational model. In a sense, human motivation is considered to resemble that of a ladder or staircase. To get a human motivated to do something, they must first satisfy specific prerequisites. Each individual prerequisite is what is called a need. So here is a visual example of Maslow's hierarchy of needs. As you can see, human motivation starts at the most primitive mindset, the mindset of human survival, and it continually grows until it reaches the end, where humans seek to master their own minds. It has a lot going for it, so let's dive a little bit into each need and link it to something in the realm of games. First, we start off with physiological needs. Humans are first and foremost animals at our core. If desperate enough, we are all capable of coming back to our animalistic ways. The core needs to our survival as an individual and to our species are through water, food, shelter, and sex. The physiological needs are self-explanatory. The basic premise of this need is that if our own lives are not in any danger, we can move on to the next level of the hierarchy of needs. Games that touch on physiological needs could be those super spicy games you find on Steam or online. Next on the hierarchy of needs are safety needs. Basically, the premise is that humans are seeking safety in a range of areas. These areas include safety in our health, emotional, financial, and personal life. In layman's terms, it's basically having a job that provides you with resources that keep you from worrying about surviving. It's after people have enough food to not worry about living, that people then move on to worrying about their health. For example, although veganism is important for our health and is cheaper for our wallets, I highly doubt a vegan will starve themselves to death if they only have access to meat and water for the next year. Regardless, games that touch on safety needs would be the types of games called play to earn. On top of that, getting a job in the game industry or starting a profitable game company would satisfy the safety needs of individuals. Next on the list is love and belonging. People are social creatures that need to love and be loved. Belonging and love is tied to our mental health. We can find love through family, friends, and spouses. We can even find belonging in local and online communities, and even in groups. It's fairly straightforward. If you find somewhere where you belong, you can then move on to the next level in the hierarchy of needs. Games that touch on social needs can include MMORPGs, cooperative games, and even the formation and contribution to gaming communities themselves. Next on the list are esteem needs. Once the physiological needs have been met, this is where people start to seek personal growth. The first area that people will seek personal growth are through esteem needs. Esteem needs touch on people's wants and needs to get validation from others. The validation will be in the form of status, recognition, fame, perhaps even attention from their achievements and contributions to society, their communities, and for their own individual sake. You can find games that touch on esteem needs through esports games, such as Overwatch and Rainbow Six Siege. You can also find esteem needs being fulfilled by the Let's Play industry where people watch other people play games. Next on the list is cognitive needs. This is where people start to seek out activities that mentally stimulate the mind. The mental stimulation can be in the form of brainstorming or even just challenging a person's creativity and curiosity. Games that touch on this need can be found through strategy games, such as poker. It can even be found in single-player games like the original Mario games and even in cooperative games. We finally reach a point where growth starts to enter the spiritual realm, and this is through the aesthetic needs. Once a person no longer seeks validation or stimulation, there seems to be a need where people just seek out immersive experiences for the sake of experiencing something unique, beautiful, and even novel at times. What a person seeks is up to debate, but generally this is a stepping stone to self-mastery. Games that touch on this could be games that allow you to explore, allow you to transport into an environment such as VR games. They could even be visual novels where stories transport you to a new world. Lastly, we reach the final stage in the hierarchy of needs, which is called self-mastery. This stage can also be referred to as self-actualization, or even transcendence. To reach this stage, you must have mastery over everything else in the motivational model. At this stage, people are seeking to accomplish being the best versions of themselves. This stage is where people seek to create things, such as writing books, drawing art, all for the sake of the art form, and not for the money. I don't know if there is even a game that touches on self-mastery. If anything, it would be where someone creates a game for the sake of the art form of making games, and nothing more. Okay, let's talk about the potential for abusing people's motivations. Psychology and its findings come with both the good and the bad. As one of my favorite movies, Castle in the Sky, once mentioned, to give power to good, you must also know evil and to never use it. Regardless, the idea is that when it comes to games, we can create motivations in players to play them. However, we can also use motivation for goals that are more nefarious in purposes. The abuse comes in the form of a simple formula: desperation plus a solution equals potential for abuse. The desperation in the formula comes in the form of someone who is desperate to satisfy a hierarchical need. There are people out there who may not be having their needs met. I'm sure you can find people anywhere in the world who are not having even their most basic needs met. However, if you give them a solution, and if the solution is quick, easy, and effective, people who are desperate, if marketed to correctly, will pay any amount of money. The marketing I'm speaking of has to target the specific motivational need that the individual is desperate to fulfill. Anyway, enough of that. Let's look at some homework. It's very straightforward, just like previous homework. All you need to do is pick a game you've played and match it to a hierarchy need in the motivational model. Don't use sequels and prequels, and remember, there are no right or wrong answers. Just try to see a correlation between motivation and the games people play. Well, that's all I have for you. Thank you so much for subscribing to my channel and liking my video. I look forward to seeing you in the next episode. Have an amazing day.